guys, and thank you so much for watching today's video. If it's your first time on my channel, welcome. My name is Anne, and if you have been here already, welcome back. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how I created this soft halo eye look, which you can wear for work, for school, or just any other occasion you want to wear it for. And besides me showing you this eye look, I also have a special announcement which I couldn't wait to share with you guys. And I think I'm just gonna say it. I have my own brush kit with Sigma Beauty. This is actually the second time teaming up with them on a brush kit. The previous time I had a brush kit, I think it's around 2 years ago. So I'm so excited to have another brush kit with them. This brush kit includes 7 brushes and it retails for $80. If you would buy like all these brushes separately, it would be $115, I believe. So you save more than $30, which I think is super awesome. So this is the kit. It has my name on it, and inside there are 7 of my favorite brushes from Sigma Beauty. If you follow me for a while on YouTube, you know that in every video I use Sigma Beauty brushes. I have been a long time fan of the brand. I think their brushes are amazing. So now to have my own brush kit with all my favorite brushes, I think it's super cool. So my brush kit with Sigma is now available. It's on their website. I have everything linked down in the description bar in case you want to get it. There's a link in the description. If you click on it, it will lead you to the website where you can get it. And then inside there are 7 brushes, which are brushes which I used all the time on my channel. So I think for those who follow all of my YouTube videos, you're not gonna be surprised that these brushes are in here. So these are the 7 brushes that come in my brush kit. The first one is the E15 Flat Diviner brush. Then we have the E25 Blending brush, the E32 Detail Diffused Crease brush, the E40 Tapered Blending brush, the E42 Precision Firm Blender brush, the E75 Angled Brow Brush, and the P84 Precision Angled Brush. So yeah, those are all the brushes which are included. I think I'm just gonna dive right into the video now because I feel like showing them like this, like it's not making a lot of sense. You guys probably wanna see them in action, which some of you have seen me using them already 1,000 times. But for the sake of today's video, I'm gonna do this eye look using all of these brushes. So we're just gonna get started. So the first thing I'm gonna do is prime my eyelids. I'm gonna use the MAC Cosmetics Pink Pot in the color Soft Ochre. And to apply this, I'm taking the P84 Precision Angled Brush, which I use in every video. I just really love the combination of this primer together with this brush. It's like a really tiny kabuki brush, which is really nice. I always use it to prime my eyelids, but you can also use it to apply concealer underneath the eyes or blend out the area underneath the outer V of the eyes when you have like some eyeshadow fallout. But I will show that later in today's video. So I'm just gonna press the eyeshadow primer all over my eyelids until I find that it looks like nicely covered, that like all the redness is gone from the eyelids. And of course, everything I'm doing at one side of my eye, I'm also doing at the other side. So in today's video, I'm gonna play with a palette which is only 4 euros, which is equal to $4. It's super affordable. I've done a similar video last week using kind of the same palette but with different colors. That one was also by Essence. So I'm gonna start with this light pinky color and the Sigma E40 brush, which is my all-time favorite blending brush. I use it in almost every video. So I'm gonna blend this shade all the way from the inner corner to the outer corner. And I'm actually going in a few more times with this color because the color payoff of this eyeshadow shade was not the best. Like I said earlier, this palette was only $4. So like, what can you expect? But you guys really seem to like the previous video where I used a really affordable palette, so I wanted to do another one. So this is definitely not the best palette I've ever used, but my mission for today's video is just to make it work and to show you like what you can achieve by using a palette which is so freaking affordable. So I just kept adding more and more until I was satisfied with how it was looking. And then I went in with this brown color
And the brush I'm using for this is the E33, which is the Detail Diffused Crease Brush. This is like a tinier version of the E40, like at the left you can see the E40 brush, and at the right you can see the Detail Diffused Crease Brush, which is in the number E33. So this is a really tiny blending brush, which is really nice. I use this brush in almost every video. It's just really nice to have like a tiny blending brush in your collection, which will help you to like blend shades in more precise areas. So I'm going to blend this all the way in the outer V and also in the inner corner area. But for my inner corner area, I'm going to switch to a different brush later. So I just kept blending and blending. Again, this was not the most pigmented shade ever, but by building it up, I think it definitely looks great. So I'm going in with the same color, but now I'm taking the Precision Firm Blender Brush, which is the E42. It's a little bit tinier than the E33, which I just used, and because the inner corner area like is a little bit more, I don't want to say like the skin is tinier or something, I don't know how to explain, but in this corner you want to use an even tinier brush. It just works better for some reason. So I'm doing the same thing as I did in the outer V. I'm just going to blend it all the way in the inner corner. And then with whatever is left on my brush, I'm going to blend it a bit more in the crease area, as you can see me doing right now. Just sweeping the brush back and forth. And then I went in with a little bit of concealer. I'm using my all-time favorite, which is the Tarte Cosmetics Shape Tape Concealer. And I'm taking the E25 blending brush, which is like a flat blending brush. And I'm gonna apply a little bit in the center of the eyelid. Now normally I would use this brush to pack on eyeshadow in the outer V, just like I did earlier using the E33 brush. But for today's look, I wanted to kind of make sure that I use every brush like in this video. So I decided to use this brush for this step, which is actually really nice. I've done this trick before. Using a soft blending brush to apply concealer on the eyelid is gonna apply it way more softer in comparison if you would use like a more of a shader brush, which is more flat. It will just become more harsh. So by using a blending brush, you can just see that the edges of where I applied the concealer, it just looks really soft and blended into the skin. And that's what I wanted. So of course I'm doing the same at the other side of the eye. Then I'm going in with this soft kind of, I don't know how to describe, it's kind of a toppy shimmery color, and I'm taking the E42 brush and I'm gonna pack on the eyeshadow in the middle part of the eyelid. Now with this eyeshadow I had a lot of fallout, as you can see underneath the eyes. So maybe it's even better to use your finger, because when you use your finger the product kind of sticks to the finger and that might work better. So now I'm taking the same brush and I'm gonna take this reddish shade and I'm just gonna blend it right next to that light color to kind of make the transition from light to dark look better, since we have like a lot of darkness in the inner corner and the outer corner, and that light color in the middle center of the eyelid, it just looks kind of harsh. So to blend it out, I used that reddish color. Now I'm going back in with the P84 Precision Angle Brush, which I used earlier to apply the eyeshadow base. So I'm gonna apply a little bit concealer. I used the Tarte Cosmetics Shape Tape Concealer again, and I'm gonna apply a little bit like straight underneath the outer end of the eyelid. This is just gonna make the whole eye look more neat, more cleaned up. I really like this trick. I think I've started doing it like for 6 months now. Normally I would just, I think, use a makeup wipe and just leave it for what it is. But I think using some concealer makes the whole eye look so much better. So now I'm going in with this Maybelline gel eyeliner, which is my favorite drugstore eyeliner. And I'm gonna take the E75 angled brow brush. Now you might think, like, why are you using a brow brush for your eyeliner? I personally just really like this brush for my eyeliner. I know Sigma Beauty also has a wink liner brush. I think that they actually have a few brushes which are meant for eyeliner. But for some reason, I just really like to use this brush. I think it's just a little bit more, it's just different, like, for some reason, I just really like it. I don't even know how to explain it, but I always gravitate to this brush for my eyeliner. So that's the reason why I wanted to use it in my brush set. Also, of course, the name speaks for itself. It's an angled brow brush, so you can also use it for your brows if you prefer that. So now I'm going in with the NYX Cosmetics Matte Liquid Liner, which is Really nice drugstore liner. I use it very often and I'm gonna use it straight on top of the gel eyeliner. I like to layer my eyeliner. By using a gel eyeliner underneath a liquid liner, it's going to look super bold, super black, and I feel like the eyeliner is gonna stand out more in comparison if you would use only a liquid liner or only a gel eyeliner. So now I'm taking the flat definer brush, which is in the number E15. I use it in every video. I just really like to use it for this particular step that I'm doing right now. I'm pressing the eyeshadow underneath the lower lash line, and that's why I really like this brush, because it's so flat, so you can work really precisely with it. So of course, doing the same thing at the other side again, just pressing and kind of sweeping the brush back and forth to make sure that the shade is everywhere. Then now for the next step, I'm going back in with the E42 brush and a little bit of that pink and brown color mixed together. And I'm going to use this to blend out the lower lash line. The E15, which was the flat definer brush I just used to press on the eyeshadow. It is a really nice brush for like packing on the eyeshadow, but afterwards you definitely want to blend it out because it does look a bit harsh. So I'm just going to sweep my brush back and forth and blend everything out until it looks really nice and smoky. Then I'm going to take this pencil from NYX Cosmetics, which I bought a few days ago when I was in Amsterdam. I was searching for more pencils which have kind of a brown warm undertone, and I found this one at NYX Cosmetics, their store, so I wanted to use it for today's video. It's a little bit darker than what I would normally use, but I felt like it actually made this look a bit more smoky, which I kind of liked. So now for my mascara, I use the Great Lash Mascara from Maybelline, and for my lashes, I'm using John Lashes from Bokai Beauty. I will make sure to link everything I'm using today in the description bar, like always. And then here you can see the end result of the eyes. Now every brush that I'm using today is also sold separately, and I have a special discount code which I will link down in the description bar.
And then this is the end of the video. I really hope you all enjoyed. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you did enjoy. That's really helpful for my YouTube channel. And also, like I said earlier, the brush kit is now available on Sigma Beauty, their website. I have everything linked down in the description bar. And yeah, I'm just really excited, and there will be a lot more videos on my channel using the brushes, so keep an eye out for that. And yeah, I just hope you all enjoyed, and hopefully I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.